Hey guys, what's up? This is Marshall Simon here on YouTube. I just want you guys to know that I haven't been watching, WWE or TNA for a while, but I heard out of the blue, Austin Aries is a brand new heavyweight champion of the world. Congratulations, Austin, for a cruiserweight, or I don't know what they call him. I think X Division? But, oh well. Yeah. I think I will watch WWE Money in the Bank, because I haven't watched a decent program for a long time, I never knew, Randy Orton got himself into some fucked up shit. Damn. How did he get suspended? It's like, well, shit happens, Look what happened to Evan Bourne, I think he's done, he's history. So, anyways, look what I got, ladies and gentlemen, from HMB Canada here in British Columbia. Ladies and gentlemen, I now bought WWE Extreme Rules 2012, Brock Lesnar and John Cena on the cover. I call it more like a street fight, like a false count anywhere, because it was no disqualification. The reason why, ladies and gentlemen, this is 14A, well, it's because of Brock Lesnar and John Cena got busted open. That was a hell of a match. I love the city of Chicago, Illinois, and the fans are loyal, so that should happen. After 8 years from the WWE, the most destructive force in history, Brock Lesnar has reemerged to bring the pain to hustle, loyalty, and respect. But John Cena refuses to be intimidated. Anyone goes when the two wage an all-out brawl to prove who the true face of WWE. Plus, Chicago's own CM Punk returns home to defend the WWE title and his family honor against Chris Jericho in a deeply personal Chicago street fight. Daniel Bryan gets a chance to avenge his record-setting loss at WrestleMania when he faced the great white Sheamus in a grueling 2 out of 3 falls match. It's time to toss out the rule book as WWE presents Extreme Rules. So, we had an Extreme Rules match, Chicago Street Fight match, 2 out of 3 falls match, tables match for the Intercontinental title, and then falls count anywhere between Orton and Kane. So, on the back, we got Bryan, Sheamus, Punk, Jericho, Cena, and Lesnar. Here you go, ladies and gentlemen. There's the 14 thing right there, and then up here, that silver thing, that's my Canadian proof WWE purchase, so thank you. And you know what? I wish I could have ordered that pay-per-view, and I think I was just too lazy and tired, and I was more into the, Stanley Cup playoffs, and The dirty Los Angeles Kings stole the cup this year, so this October, and when LA comes to Van, payback is going to be such a mother to Jonathan Quick and Dustin Brown, Dustin Pinner, because you're public enemy number one when you come to Vancouver. So anyways, now, the most, I think, I don't know, it's not that bad. I finished disc 1 and 2. This is called WWE Falls Count Anywhere. That's Stone Cold Steve Austin, Mick Foley, Triple H and HBK on the cover. And I'll tell you what it says. The greatest street fights and other out-of-control matches. It's amazing, It's pretty wild, Some people found it disappointing. And it's hosted by my favorite hardcore legend, Mick Foley. And on the back, Triple H and Mick Foley, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Here's what I got on the inside. Rey Mysterio, Batista from Friday Night SmackDown, Hardcore Holly, and Al Snow, ladies and gentlemen. See that? This was from WWE Fully Loaded and Friday Night SmackDown. So, anyways, I'll show you the inside, okay? Alright. Don't mind me. I'm just going to take out disc 1, 2, and 3 so I can show you, ladies and gentlemen, the pictures. Here we go. Number 1. That's Booker T and Road Warrior, the late Road Warrior Hawk, WWE Hall of Famer. Stone Cold Steve Austin with WWE Hall of Famer Bret the Hitman Hart. And Cody Rhodes. That was from SmackDown, because that's Randy Orton he was fighting, and hopefully Randy gets his shit together, you know. He shouldn't fuck up big time. Look what happened to Kurt Angle. He did it because he wanted to go to TNA and work for Dixie Carter, the enemy. Anyways, I'll tell you what's on there. Disc 1, the name may vary. Pat Patterson versus WWE Hall of Famer Sergeant Slaughter in an alley fight at MSG. WWE Hall of Famer Jim Valiant. That's the Valiant Brothers with Miss Atlanta Lively versus the Midnight Express at WCW Starrcade, NWA Starrcade, Doom. That was Ron Simmons and the Natural Butch Reed with Teddy Long against Barry Windham and Arn Anderson. Then there was Sting versus Mick Foley, the Macho Man, ooh yeah, Randy Savage versus Bryan Adams, Crush. And then Windy City, Booker T and Sting versus the Road Warriors, Animal and Hawk, WWE Hall of Famers. Then there was Ahmed Johnson teaming up with Hall of Famers, LOD against Hall of Famer Ron Simmons. I used to call Savio Vega Sinbad because he was like, hey man, what's up with that? He looked like Sinbad and Bryan Adams. So, but at the end, we got Austin versus Bret the Hitman Hart. Disc 2, multiple personalities. That was Mick Foley when he had Mankind, Dude Love, and Cactus Jack. He took on Triple H on Monday Night Raw in 97. Taz versus Bam Bam Bigelow. Damn, that was pretty damn good because of Joey Styles. Oh my god! You know, and that was a hell of a good match. And a brand new title, Al Snow versus Hardcore Bob Holly. You know, at St. Valentine's Massacre, sorry. I thought it was Fully Loaded. So, it was The Rock versus Triple H and Fully Loaded when the Nation, or with, DX or the Corporate. I don't know who was in who. And then Tess versus Shane McMahon at SummerSlam 1999. And then after that, Dick Couture's on a power trip. The Big Show was the WWE champ versus Kane. And then on another hardcore match, Crash Holly versus the Headbangers. That was pretty wild. At a, what do you call it, indoor carnival, which was pretty damn nice. Mr. McMahon versus Shane O'Mac. And then finally, the Royal Rumble 2002, Ric Flair versus Mr. McMahon. And now, let's go to Disc 3. The greatest comeback story, Shawn Michaels versus Triple H. I heard that was pretty wild. SummerSlam 2002, Insurrection 2003, Triple H versus Kevin Nash, who we knew as Big Daddy Cool Diesel, inside the Divas locker room. It was Melina versus Mickie James, you know. I miss those two. Street Fight, Triple H versus Umaga, the late Umaga, that was Afa and Sika's nephew or grandson, you know. And then another one, John Cena versus Umaga, and then New Stars on the Rise, DX versus Legacy, that was Cody Rhodes and Ted DiBiase Jr. And then from there, the Street Fight, that was Mysterio versus Batista to be the number one contender for the World Heavyweight title. The Street Fight, Randy Orton versus Cody Rhodes, that's the last one out of all, and that's okay, and I think that's the way to end. And then after that, Mick Foley does a heck of a lot of tidying up. I was like, okay, wow. So here you go, ladies and gentlemen, there's my menu. They make the thing really small, you know, and they stop giving us, you know, inserts. And you know what, right now, I've been, you know, going on a road trip, you know, trying to find the next adventure, you know. I'm learning how to do the turntable, you know, and I think I'm looking to becoming a DJ. And you know what, you will know me as DJ Sly, but I'm not going to miss one of the greatest pay-per-views of all time, the 25th anniversary of SummerSlam. It's going to be in Los Angeles, as usual. You know what, WWE, you got to start exploring. Bring SummerSlam to Miami, Orlando, Jacksonville, or Sunrise, Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Explore Florida, because you know why? It's a hell of a tan. So, thanks for watching. This is Marshall Simon by saying, so long. Peace out.